Hi, I'm looking at integrated space weather analysis. Three angstroms here, 211, 193, 171, and three angstroms over here. And this object there just blows away there. This, I showed this yesterday. This is not the best view of it, but it's not horrible. Object, its blast comes off the sun, pushes it away. So that goes back to Dr. Sylvia Albers and gravitational constant, which has been held in high esteem for hundreds of years, is not. It's not a true thing to go with, so everybody's wrong if they're using that gravitational constant, because it's not holding up. The theory's not holding up under observation, so it's not true. So here's a 211 angstrom. What I've been calling coronal holes are this big, and I've been showing you the helio viewer, which just shows these little spots. I never quite understood it, but the helio viewer did show north and south poles as coronal holes. So here's another model from NASA I found, and this is showing these coronal holes like I've been saying. But this doesn't show the north and south poles as coronal holes. So I guess this just is keeping track of coronal holes that will come and face the Earth, I guess, because these obviously won't, unless the sun tilts. Anyway, so I thought that was an interesting one. Here is our solar winds, the collapsing magnetopause. You can see it's collapsing. And the top is collapsing, I'm guessing, because all this energy is coming in from above the Earth somewhere. Sun's on the right, solar winds, kilometers per second. It didn't reach 1,000 that I saw, 900 something once, I think. But this shows all the energy on the backside of the Earth. And my time lapse yesterday showed a magenta object moving through the veil, not clearly at all, but that's what I'm coming up with from my observations. Anyway, so this is a Dutch Sense. He's the guy you want to go look at for anything related to earthquakes. No matter where you are in the world, he goes over the world every day and predicts earthquakes, and he's about 80% accurate. So it just shows the USGS, who said you could not predict earthquakes, is full of it, although they've changed recently. So there's lots of little earthquakes out here. These are recent earthquakes. This is, what, the 10th on here, I think. Anyway, so that's interesting, because I look at the sulfur dioxide coming up, and I think I said yesterday this one is starting. I mean, look at that island. There can't be many cars on our industry, I don't believe. And there's lots of sulfur dioxide out here in the ocean. So that's interesting. It might be a new bubbling. And then we've got all this going on down here at the Galapagos. And of course, Hawaii looks like it's more is happening, because it was at 400 yesterday, or 389 or something. So there's almost 600. So I would say that is bubbling more, and I don't even look at the news about that. I just look at Dutch Sense, because that's all I need to look at. And then, you know, pollution everywhere in the world. Go to air, 250, which is about jet stream altitude, 34,000 or whatever. And you can just see the jet streams are just all messed up. Look at that one, just goes across the equator. Never used to happen a few years ago. So that's going to affect crops, food crops for humans. Going to affect, I don't know what it's going to mess everything up slowly. But you just want to keep looking at it so you know what's going on. Okay, thanks.